Hello everyone, welcome to my first video. My name is Turk Tactical. Usually I stream on Twitch, so this YouTube thing is still a bit new to me, but we're just gonna get right into it. I got a lot of people asking me in my Twitch or my Twitter about their Pokemon's IVs and if they're adequate enough for PvP. Honestly, usually I don't know off the top of my head. Partly because I don't know all the matchups, all the IV dependent matchups, but also because it's partly a personal thing, dependent on your play style and how you like to use that particular Pokemon. So today I'm gonna show you guys how to figure it out yourself, quick and dirty. So the easiest way I found to figure out if your IVs are adequate enough is to use the Matrix Simulator from PvPoke. To get to this Matrix Simulator, you go to the Battle tab, go to Single Battle, and you press Matrix Battle. What the Matrix Simulator allows you to do, it allows you to simulate two groups of Pokémon against each other. In our case, we're gonna simulate a group of the Pokémon you're considering building versus the meta you want to use it in. Today I'll be using Sableye as an example, but this really works with any Pokémon. I have a 14-12-14 Shadow Sableye I've been considering building for Great League, so I really want to figure out if it's good enough versus the meta before investing in such a Pokemon. So what you do is you just add Sableye to the left side. I'll start by adding my IVs, Shadow Sableye. My IVs are 14. 12, 14, and I want to run it with Power Gem, and you want to compare it to the perfect one. So I'll also put in the perfect one. Again, it's Shadow. You can just change that here as well. There we go, the perfect one. And because I'm considering a body boosting it as well, I'll add the level 40 ones to it too. Let's see what the level 41 ones. Shadow 41, that's the perfect one. That's also at the 14, 12, 14 one. And then we need perfect Shadow, level 41 with Power Gem again. All right, and we were gonna simulate that against the Great League meta. And luckily PvPoke has the Great League meta already built in. Just go to Quick Fill, Custom Group, Great League meta, and there you go, 43 mons already in, which is great. You might wanna check this real quick, see if everything you expect to say to face is in here. And if you do, you can just edit right here. But this looks about right. So once you've done that, you can change some options. You can change the shoot scenario. You can do the no shoot versus no shoot maybe. What I usually just like to do, I like to keep it as one at one shoot for at the beginning, and I like to keep it at the default IVs. Later you can change that, but default IVs is about what you can expect in most of your matches. There you just click battle. And there you go. So how this works, there's a lot of numbers. These are the battle scores that PvPoke gives them. Every score above 500 is a win for Sableye. All the scores below 500 is a loss for Sableye, just like we're used to in the battle simulations. What you're gonna do is you're just gonna scroll through this list and see if the your Sableye or your Pokemon is any different than the regular Pokemon. Just looking at here, Abomasnow, my 14-12-14 Sableye has a 743 threat score or battle score, and the regular or the 100% one has a 745. That's not a big difference. That's negligible. And it looks like that's the same for Altaria, Azumarill, Bastiodon, for all of these. So it's gonna scroll through slowly, still looking the same. Still looking pretty much the same. They're all looking the same. So right now it's looking like there's no difference. Ooh, but here we go. There is a small difference between, or pretty big difference between the perfect one and my one. So I'm just gonna write that down real quick. Just gonna grab my notepad. Loss to Registeel. And we're gonna delve into these matchups a little closer once we've written all these down. The mirror, of course, that's CMP based. So that's, of course, that's always something you have to watch out for. Since my Sableye is 14 attack, you will lose to 15 attack ones in the mirror. That's to be expected. These are still looking the same. Ooh, looks like Swampert is a loss for my Sableye, but it's only a win for the level 41 Sableye. Right, I'll write that down. Loss to Swampert. Looks like it's the same for Venusaur. So what we learned from looking at this matrix is that compared to the 100% Shadow Sableye, my Sableye loses the matchup to Registeel, Swampert and Venusaur. But before we jump to conclusions, let's just check out these matchups real quick and see if they are really that important. Let's just take a look at the Venusaur matchup first. This is the level 41 perfect one. And as we can see, it gets to the foul play right before a frenzy plant. I think that might matter. If I put in my stats again, 14, 12, 14. It seems as if it's a CMP based matchup. Sableye and Venusaur have really similar attack. You can't see it here because when you're simulating Shadow Pokemon, you have to keep in mind that the CMP is decided with the regular Sableye base stats. So I'm just gonna change this to a regular Sableye real quick. And 14, 12, 14. And yes, indeed, it has 122 attack as a regular Sableye, and it's 123 for Venusaur. So yeah, Venusaur would win the CMP if I would have 15 attack for 41. Sableye wins CMP versus Venusaur. So considering I usually use it as a swap-in, I usually have an energy advantage anyway. And so this matchup doesn't really matter to me that much. If you were using your Sableye as a lead and you expect to run into Venusaur leads, then yes. Then this matchup might matter quite a lot. But considering I use it as a swap-in, I don't think I really care that much. So I'll just add that to my notes as well. And well, I can already tell you it's the same case with Swampert. Swampert has pretty similar stats. It's pretty similar attack to Sableye as well. So it's also a CMP based matchup. And again, I don't think I really care that much because I'm usually not leading my Sableye anyway. If I run it into a Swampert, I'll probably have an energy advantage or an energy deficit if I swap it into it. Yeah. The matchup versus Registeel is a little different. But take a look at my Sableye, 14, 12, 14. I just barely don't get to the foul play right here. You look at the perfect one. It just barely reaches it, survives at 1 HP. So that's a really, really tight matchup. So that doesn't always happen, especially with the way I use Sableye. I swap it in, I usually take one fast move damage from a Pokemon before, and then Registeel comes in. Even with a perfect one, I probably don't win the ones. So again, I don't think I really care. But I'm gonna chalk it up as a close loss. So then you kind of have to decide for yourself. Am I okay with these small losses? Do I want to invest in this imperfect Sableye, or do I want to wait? Personally, I'm going to invest in my Sableye just because it doesn't lose that much in a one-to-one. And if I get a perfect one eventually, I can easily grind the resources to make a new one. I live out in a pretty good area of Pokemon Go, so I can afford to build some imperfect PvP ones and build another one when I get a perfect. If you don't have those resources, I would consider maybe waiting a little bit. But that's all personal preferences. So this method right now is not perfect. We've only covered the one-to-one shield scenario now. If you want to make this analysis even more robust, you could consider doing the no shield versus no shield scenario and looking at the different outcomes. You could do the two shields versus two shields scenario. You could even consider doing the one to two shields, or maybe even the zero to two shields. Maybe not that one. It doesn't appear that much, but if you want to be really robust, you can. You might even consider doing giving all your opponents the maximum stat product. It's really all up to you. And the more matrices you make, the more robust your analysis will be. Just depends on how much time you wanna invest into analyzing if your Pokemon is adequate enough. If you got the resources, I would not bother. I would just build it, enjoy it. You'll figure it out along the way. But if you wanna really find out if it's good enough before you try it out in Go Battle League, take your time. Right, so right now we've only covered Sableye, which maxes below 1500 CP. What if you have a Pokemon that maxes above 1500 CP? What mons would you, what IVs would you compare it to? It all depends. Let's just say we take Shiftry, 10, 15 IV is the one I have, for example. I would always sim it against the perfect one and the default one. And sometimes I'll also sim it against the maximized attack one, because there might be some breakpoints that pop up. Again, same thing, one-to-one shield. And we do the exact same as we did versus for Sableye. You just look at the matrix, write down what matches yours wins and loses compared to the perfect one, the default one, and then decide if you're okay with those discrepancies. Right, so that covers it all. I hope this video was useful for you. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave them down in the comments below or ask them in my Twitch channel. I stream every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday at 7 p.m. Central European time. That's around noon Central time. Have a good day.